I'm a huge fan of the theorizer, and this is about a theory that the theorizer has made. This is about the black cat who's in Coraline. This is a theory about Coraline, okay? So, he believes that the black cat is evil, and I don't agree. At least I don't want to. So, for the people who have not watched Coraline, I will explain it a little. Maybe really detailed, but you know. So, the movie is about someone named Coraline Jones. She moves into a place called a Pink Palace apartment, which was originally a house which is 150 years old. Coraline then goes to go find a secret well that's apparently somewhere there. And as you can see in this picture, that's what she's doing. Then she goes and finds the well. This is where she finds the well, and there's the black cat. The black cat is YB's best friend. She meets YB, and then they separate. She goes to her house and YB leaves a doll that looks just like her. And then she finds a bricked up door. She asked her mom to unlock it and figured out, once her mom had unlocked it, that it was all bricked up. Now, as you can see, there's a weird button on that. So, while Coraline was sleeping, she wakes up to the sound of a jumping mice. She thinks she's dreaming, though. She follows the mice to the door, and she opens the door and finds that it's not brick up and has a huge tunnel. She goes into it, still thinking that it's a dream, and she's just imagining this in her head. And then she goes into a different world. This world is a better world than the reality world that she lives in. She goes in, it's completely different. There was a picture of a little blue boy in the ice cream falls. And in this one, it isn't. She comes face to face with the Belldown, which is the other mother. She is in her mother version, but with button eyes. This other mother makes the world way better. The other mother makes the meals instead of the dad, which in the real world, the dad makes the meals, which Coraline did not. So I'm just gonna skip to the end of the movie now. In the end, she finds out that she's not really dreaming. The Belldown takes her parents. She goes back and gets her parents. The Belldown turns into this and shows her true form of the Belldown. And then she saves her parents, and you know, it ends happily. And she explains it to YB's grandmother, what happened. Now let's get to the cat theory. The theorizer said that the cat tried to stop Coraline from throwing the key away, but once he figured out she's going to put it in the well, that he didn't mind once he figured out that she was going to put it in the well. I think he stopped her because she was going to put it in the well, and he somehow knew that. Because, as he said, he could sense things. Because he said the other YB could talk to him, even though the other YB couldn't talk. And he was able to communicate with him, though. And this cat says he's been going there for years, and that the other mother doesn't like cats. So why would he be trying to help her if he's a cat and the other mother does not like cats? That is my one question. So I'm saying that he's not evil. I don't believe. And in the end, when she turns into that spider-like creature, she said, "And you brought vermin with you?" She said vermin. I doubt he's an accomplice of hers. I do not think he's evil or trying to help. He also told YB to watch her when she moved in because he knew she was in trouble because he's been going. He knew that the other mother was going to attack her because she's a kid. And she tends to attack kids to make the world, her world look better than the world that they actually live in. Also, he says he's been going there for years, so he's probably been spying on her to see what she was going to do. And he went there after Coraline to try to stop her, because he knew what would happen. Luckily, Coraline didn't do it, and also, I do not think if he was an accomplice, I don't think he'd be terrified of her, because Coraline threw him at the other mother's face, and he tore her eyes off. I don't think he would do that if he was an accomplice. Plus, the other mother seemed to really hate him. So I highly doubt that he's an accomplice. He's been going there for years spying on her, and I believe he might have tried to stop the other kids. And about his transporting magic, I am not sure. I think he might have got that from going into the other mother's realm. Somehow he got that from there, but I'm not sure how he... Now, I just want to remind you guys, I said I'm a huge fan of the theorizer. I love the theory he does, and I subscribe to him. But, and I'm not saying that I'm better at doing this, because to be honest, I am really bad at doing this kind of thing, but I'm a huge fan of theorizer, but I just want to tell him that I disagree and give him some points. I hope he'll watch this and understand how huge of a fan I am. By points, I mean...